Kris, you seem to go really strong to the basket, play with a lot of confidence tonight. Is that a different, are you just your senior year?
Pretty much. Senior year, this is it. I mean, JK and I have been here, you know, since the beginning, and I'm like, tired of things being how they were in the past, so I'm trying to make a change.
What was different in those first, for both of you, what was different in the first few minutes of the second half?
Well, I think we just gave up, you know, a couple of open threes. They made some shots. So that probably was the biggest key, you know. But we didn't give in. We stayed with it. We stayed from the sound. So, you know, they're going to make some, but eventually, last style of play, we was hoping that they're going to die on the line, which eventually they got tired on them. So our style of play kind of with their legs out. They started to miss some shots that they made in the second half.
Did you guys feel more comfortable right now, after a year under coach, and do you think this year will be better because you're more familiar with the
style? Definitely, no question. Just, you know, with the chemistry we've been able to build, you know, starting with last year and, you know, with the new group of guys that we have, with the time we spent over in France and so on, like, yeah, definitely going a long way.
Pretty resilient, though, too. I mean, they made some shots and cut. They got as close as five.
Yeah, they did. They got pretty close.
But talk about your, you know, you guys were able to come back and you were resilient.
Oh, yeah. Just because we really just, you know, remember that we can't hang our heads on every point that they score, that we got to bounce back. And, you know, if they give us two, we got to answer with, you know, three times as much. And, you know, like, they don't make runs, we got to make runs, we got to get stops, you know. So it's like, it's up to us to kind of kill their momentum and not really get hung up on how the game goes.
Also, I think our bench played really well. Like, Charles and Jamie came on, gave us a boost, so that was that was key.
Jeremiah, you're wearing number 11. You scored 11 points on 11-11-11. Does that mean anything to you?
Yeah, he actually, Ray actually reminded me that day.
To stop at 11, right? Yeah, he said, don't score no more.
But, you know, I'm not good with the numbers, but the win is more important, so it sounds good. I might go tweet it or something.
What kind of game, I mean, you win your first game, what kind of pace do you think it sets for the rest of the season? Being that you won by like 20 points.
With this, the league we in, we got to win these games, so we got to take one game at a time. We can't, this is a game that we're supposed to win, that we feel like we're supposed to win, so we got to have a quick turnaround, and we got to move forward. We can't dwell on this game, you know. We're supposed to win it, so we expect to win every game, so we got to move on to the next one.
You know, I thought it was a good opening game for us. Obviously, I was pleased to see us get off to a pretty good start, you know, shooting the basketball. I thought a couple things happened with that. You always, you know, you take shots when you can make them, but I thought we didn't do a very good job of reacting to making some shots early. Our defensive edge kind of went in and out in the first half. First two or three baskets they got were threes where we just didn't close out with a sense of urgency, and that continued to plague us throughout the course of the game. So I thought we lost our defensive edge there a little bit. But obviously, in the second half, once we got into the half, we continued to guard, and it started to pay dividends for us. A couple of quick turnovers, a couple of big makes, and we got control of the game again. And then I thought our guards did a good job in that last 6 minutes of controlling the basketball, getting us good shots, as well as using some clock. Good opening game. Our goal, of course, is to get 40 good minutes with a defensive edge and all those things. And we didn't get that tonight, but, you know, Monday we'll look to get, you know, closer to that. Maybe we'll play 20, 25 good minutes tonight, and hopefully we can play a few more than that on Monday. I don't know much about them yet. I saw just a little bit of them on tape. It'll be a quick athletic team, so it could make for an exciting game. Well, that's great. No, we shot the ball really well tonight. We can shoot the ball like that every night. You know, probably be really, really happy with our offense just in terms of shooting the ball. We got some inside play. We got the ball. Cleve scored inside. Of course, Kris scored some inside. And then we had guys making jump shots. Moses and J.K. Jamie Crockett came in, gave us a lift for some shots. So offensively, I don't have a whole lot to complain about in terms of us making making shots. And we could have taken some better ones and maybe made shot an even higher percentage, but we're okay there. It's that defensive edge and urgency and putting your foot on a team when you got them down. We didn't have that the entire night, I didn't think.
Were you encouraged that it seems like there's a little bit more resiliency with the team, that they didn't come in?
I just said we're better. We got that's yet to be proven, but I think we're better. We're deeper. And we've got some more experience. Brandon and Moses and Cleve played a lot of basketball last year. Now that Kris and JK are seniors, we're still young, but we got a lot more experience than we had last year. Quality experience, and you add a few athletes, and now we can get a little deeper into the game. Worrell's been playing real well, and I don't think he played that well tonight. I think he's going to give us some good minutes. It's kind of being new in the system kind of showed a little bit tonight. Getting Donovan Kirk back in a couple of games, that's going to help. So I think we are better, and I think we are also more resilient, just like you said. We just got to go out and prove that and get better.
Did you like the way Brandon pushed the tempo early on?
Well, later, actually. I didn't think he pushed it as well as as much as we wanted him to early. I thought our defensive edge went away, and I thought his aggressiveness kind of went away there a little bit. And I thought that when we put him in the second half, all that was back, and it makes a big difference when he's pushing and penetrating and getting the ball to the other guys, as well as making a couple of shots and then getting to the basket.
Faber didn't commit a foul until just about 4 minutes left.
Kris really has played well this summer and in the preseason. He didn't play well in that exhibition game the other night, which is out of character for the way he's been playing. So I was just good. I was happy to see him get off to a good start, not get in foul trouble, and maybe that's a springboard for him to play the way he's been playing all summer and all fall. And it's time. He's a senior. It's time.
Coach, you said your defensive pressure was on and off all game. What specifically was working for you when it was on?
I thought that we obviously got some traps and some steals there, but when our pressure is really good is when we don't get the steal, when we get back to half court, we fix it to pressure and we sustain it, and so it's hard for them to reverse the ball even in a half court. I thought we'd get back, and we wouldn't even pick up the guy, with the ball. And just a little slow on it. And when you've got a team that really shoots the ball well, they had four or five guys could really shoot it well, and you're slow on the uptick with your transition, they're going to take that three. And they make sometimes they miss them, and it doesn't look bad. When they make them, it looks bad. And this is a good shooting team.